Hi everyone. Today I wanted to talk about a tool that I use quite often when teaching classes, Cloud9. Just an aside before we get started, this isn't sponsored by Cloud9. I just really like their tool. So what is Cloud9? Cloud9 is an online IDE, which stands for Integrated Development Environment. It's a place where you can both write and run code. Normally, you would code with an IDE on your machine, where your code is saved and run locally. With Cloud9, your entire workspace exists in the cloud, from the code you write to where you run it. What are the benefits of using an online IDE like Cloud9? One of the biggest ones for me when I'm teaching is that every environment is the same. Local installs can be a pain, since every system is slightly different, and every user has slightly different permissions on their computer. Cloud9 removes that issue, because every environment is standardized. Another benefit is that, because it's in the cloud, it can be accessed anywhere. I use Cloud9 for many of my personal projects, since I generally move around several different computers during the day. Cloud9 also integrates with many services to make it easy to manage and deploy your code. There's integrations for GitHub and Bitbucket, meaning you're not logged into saving your code on Cloud9. There's also multiple integrations for deploying your code, including but not limited to Heroku, AWS, and Microsoft Azure. Last but not least, it's possible to share your workspace with other people. This is incredibly helpful if you're stuck and could use another set of eyes, but that set of eyes isn't in the same room as you. You can even let the other person modify your code if you want. What are some of the downsides of Cloud9? As I said, I adore Cloud9, but there's some things you should be aware of. First, it's online only. This isn't something you can use if you're going to be without internet for a while. Second, sometimes I run into lag issues. For the most part, using it is seamless, but I have had it time out for a few seconds, which can be annoying if you're in the flow. Cloud9 does offer a free tier, but at that tier, all of your workspaces are technically public. What this means is that any C9 user can see the code you write. They can't modify it, though, and they can't access it in your terminal. This means that any sensitive information, like secret keys or passwords, should not be stored in your code, but set as environment variables. This should be the case for all of your code anyway, but it's especially important here. Finally, even with the free tier, you do have to provide a credit card to sign up. According to Cloud9, this is to help prevent abuse of the system. Check the link in the description to read the whole thread about this change, including some workarounds. With all that said, let's create a workspace. From your dashboard, select Create a New Workspace. From here, you have a few options. Each of these is basically a shortcut for that kind of project, installing all the things you need and sometimes setting up a basic file structure. You can also clone from an existing repo. I almost always choose blank, though. I prefer to set up things my own way, but you should do what works best for you. Once you click Create, it'll take a little bit for Cloud9 to create your workspace. If you're a Sublime Text user, this interface should look really familiar. Let's go over the various windows. The sidebar contains your directory structure and all your files. The main area is where you'll do all your coding. At the bottom is your terminal, where you'll do all of your command line stuff, like running code or installing things. If you hit the window icon, it'll toggle full screen mode. Virtualenv Wrapper isn't installed by default, so the first thing I generally do is install it using sudo pip install virtualenv wrapper. Even though you can create an environment for each of your projects, you should still always be in the habit of using virtualenvs. I also almost always delete the README file, but if this is your first time using Cloud9, it doesn't hurt to read it and visit some of the links they provide. If you come back to your environment later, everything will be just as you left it, from the pages that are open to where your cursor was. And that's it. If you have any questions, hit me up in the comments or track me down on Twitter.